who is attending this service, we pray, Lord Father, for a mighty outpouring of the Holy Spirit, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord Father God, places cannot be a barrier, O Lord Father. Language is never a barrier, O Lord Father. The lifestyle is never a barrier, O Lord Father, for your Holy Spirit to penetrate, O Lord Father. We pray, Lord Father, no matter where we are, O Lord Father, Lord, if our hearts are prepared, O Lord Father, to receive you, O Lord, to receive your presence more in our life, Lord, to worship you with all that we have, Father God. Once again, we want to bless your name this morning, O Lord. We commit all the songs into your hands. We commit the word into your hands. We commit your table into your hands, Lord Father. Bless us with your presence, O Lord Father. Once again, Lord Father, thank you for hearing our humble prayer. We ask in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. So church, yeah, okay. So we know that we serve an awesome God. Amen. Okay, whoever is there here, y'all can just respond. Amen, amen. Even people who are there online, you can respond wherever you are. No need, not telling to unmute, but you can respond there. Okay, it matters to God a lot. Amen. So we would like to today to sing songs that would declare the name of Jesus. That we would declare the authority that we have in Jesus' name. I would like to take you to the story of David and Goliath. You know, the secret is there. Even David recognized its secret. When Goliath came to him, David had only one thing to say, that you come to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thy head from thee. And David goes on to tell how the Lord is going to give victory to him because he's going in the name of the Lord. This is the name that we are going to lift up high. Okay? It deserves a lot. It deserves a lot of praise. It deserves a lot of worship. Philippians chapter 2 verse 7 says, Philippians chapter 2 verse 9 to 11 says, wherefore God has also exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Yes, Lord, we have come here, Father God, to declare your name, Lord Father, in the presence of Jesus. In Isaiah and Jeremiah it says that In the presence of Jesus, in the presence of the Lord, there is restoration, there is rest, there is blessing, there is protection, there is provision. Yes, Lord, more than that, Father, we want to just enjoy your presence, O Lord, Father God. We want to just go deeper into your love, Father God, this morning. We thank you, Lord Father. Thank you for your presence, O Lord Father. We thank you for your amazing grace, O Lord Father, that surpasses all wisdom, all knowledge, O Lord, all practicality, O Lord Father. We bless your name and we thank you, Lord Father God. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We're going to sing this song, This is Amazing Grace. There are questions that are asked. Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is so mighty and so stronger? Who is he? It's a name that is above every name. Who is the Lord who can shake the whole earth in holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless? That's the name that we are going to worship this day.
My cross.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. He is worthy. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Change
my life and back to where the past. I want to shout it from every room. Bless your holy name, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. What a beautiful name you are. Yours is the Lord Jesus. The name that is so powerful, so wonderful. And Lord, there is victory in your name. And we believe that this morning, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We bless you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's sing with all that we have. This beautiful song. Singing of how great our God is.
Amen, Jesus.
Like how Jinsy said this morning, this day is the day that we declare how great our God is. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
The name of Jesus.
Shaking up the earth.
wonderful name. Nothing compares, nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. What a wonderful name. Hallelujah. There's nothing that can be compared to your name, O Father God. There's nothing that is equal. There's nothing that is above. We thank you, Jesus. We bless your holy name, O Father God. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Have your way, God. Have your way in our lives, Lord.
Deuteronomy 31:6 says, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. We bless your name, O Father God. So today, even as Jessica will help us with the next song, I request all of us to just look back at our lives. I'm sure we have gone through so many situations, so many battles, so many struggles. And we can surely today stand here and look back and say, never once has he ever left alone.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord, hallelujah.
He's never left us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's worship him this morning.
Amen. Jesus, thank you, Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
You never was. Did you leave us on our own? Oh God, you are faithful. God, you are faithful. And every step we are breathing in your grace. Oh God, nevermore we'll be breathing out your praise. God, you are faithful. God, you are faithful. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own. You are faithful. God, you are faithful.
Holy name of Father God. Lord, even as we are in your presence, Father God, we pray, Lord, that you will be with us, Jesus. Strengthen us, Lord. Minister to us, oh Father God. Let your word pierce through our hearts, oh Father God, and touch us, oh Father. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
God's will, God's way, and God's timing. So God has a will for us. He has a plan and purpose for each one of us. And we learned about the will of God last Sunday. Today, I want to speak about God has a way. And God's ways. If God has a plan for you, if God has a will for you, and God has a way to accomplish that will in your personal life. And then God has a timing. God has a specific, you know, time to accomplish, do certain things in our life. So he will do that at his right time. So today, you know, I want to just speak about this part of this message, you know, God's way. So we know about God's will now. Now let's see what about God's way in our life. What is God's way? And God's way simply, you know, indicate the ways and means that God uses to work in our life. If God has a plan and purpose for our life, God has a way to accomplish that. You know, God is not a human being. His plans, his ways of dealing with us, his ways of accomplishing things in our life is totally different. He has a specific manner of working in our life, specific ways of working in our life and accomplishing his purpose in our personal life. So God's way simply refers God's ways of accomplishing things in us, God's manner of accomplishing things in our personal life. And let me tell you that if he has a plan for you and if he has revealed that plan to you, that will to you, remember this thing, he also will make a way for that. He will make a way. He is a way maker. And God has chosen Cyrus to conquer nations and bring a kind of political alignment in that time. And Isaiah says in 45 verse number 2 onwards, God said to Cyrus, I will go before you and level the exalted places. I will break in pieces the doors of bronze and cut through the bars of iron. Here very clearly says, God has a purpose for Cyrus. Now he is going to go before Cyrus and he is going to bring down every exalted places. He is going to break every closed doors, every iron doors, and he is going to make a way for Cyrus. That's why he said, if he has a plan for you, he is the way maker, not us. He is the way maker. He is going to go before you and make a way for you. Hallelujah. He is a way maker. And in this particular context about Cyrus, the exalted places may be referring those walls, you know, that surrounds the cities and nations to protect them from enemies. And God says, I will bring down all those exalted walls. And those bronze doors and iron bars represent basically the city gates. So Bible here says God will go before and destroy all the hindrances and make a way for Cyrus to do his purposes, achieve his plans on this earth. Dear church, I want to tell you that if God has given you a dream, if God has given you a vision in your personal life, he is the way maker, not us. He will make a way for you to accomplish that purpose in your personal life. Today, anyone is actually struggling to see an open door in your life, I want to tell you that you don't need to worry. You need to simply align yourself in the will of God. And God will go before you and he will make a way for each one of us. Listen very carefully. When God gives a vision to us, we don't need to actually worry because he is going to assume the responsibility of that vision. He is going to assume the responsibility of achieving that vision, in accomplishing that vision in our personal life. That's why I want to tell you that God is a way maker. Amen. Hallelujah. He is a way maker. And we know about several examples from the Bible how he made ways for people. And we know about Red Sea. When Israelites came to Red Sea, they had no other option. The only option they had to go and surrender themselves to Pharaoh. But they didn't want to do that. And what God did, he opened, he made a way for them in Red Sea. We know about Jordan. God made a way for them in Jordan. We know about Jericho. We know about those 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. How Jesus multiplied that and fed thousands of people. I want to tell you that from all these examples, you can see how God made a way for people who moved according to his will and plans. Today, I want to remind you from the Bible, if he has a plan for you, if he has a vision for your life, he will accomplish, he will make a way for each one of us. Hallelujah. And even Bible says in Isaiah chapter, 43, verse number 19, behold, I am doing new things. Now I spring forth. Do you not perceive him? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Making a way in wilderness and having a river in desert seems to be an impossible task. But Bible says here in place, God will make a way in wilderness. God can bring a river in desert. That means sometimes we see every door is closed. There seems to be no way. But I want to tell you that still God has a way. God will make a way for each one of us when we live according to his will. God will make a way where there seems to be no way for us to go forward. That's our God. He is a way maker. Amen. But the thing is that his ways are different from us. Isaiah chapter 45 verse number 8 says, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than higher than your thoughts. Bible very clearly says that human thoughts will come anywhere closer to God's thought. Human ways will not come anywhere near to God's ways. His ways are higher than our ways. Dear church, listen very carefully that point. He is God. He is not human beings like us. He is omnipotent. He is omniscient. He knows everything. He has almighty power. So his ways are always higher than our ways, and His ways are higher than us because He's omnipotent and omniscient. God's ways are higher than us because He knows how to mysteriously work in our life and bring wonders before our own eyes. And we can say God's ways are, you know, higher than us because He will work in an unimaginable way, because He is God. He can do it. Nothing is impossible with God. And I have seen so many times people saying this, even some of us saying that, I never imagined that I would get this job. I never imagined that I will come up in my life in this way. I never imagined that the salary, I will be able to draw a salary that I am drawing today. I never imagined that I would stay a house like the house that I am staying today. All those unimaginable things happen in your life because God made a way for you in different times, in an unusual way, in a miraculous way, in a supernatural way. That's why I want to tell you that God's ways are always different from our way. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And the thing is that God always shows that way to each one of us. He won't hide that way. At right time, when we live in right relationship with God, keeping our life in the center of God's will, He will reveal that way for each one of us. And Psalms number 32, verse number 8 says, I will instruct you, teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eyes upon you. Very clearly, God promises each one of us that He will instruct us. He will teach us the way we must go. There are places, there are times we get confused. We do not know what kind of choice that we need to make, what kind of decision that we need to make. But remember this thing, God can instruct you. God can show you the steps that you need to take. The only thing that you need to do, just to pray. And there is a beautiful example in the Bible, in Exodus chapter 33, where Moses prayed for revelation of God's ways. And Moses is a person tried to do everything in his way. Do you know that? Many, many years ago, Moses was in the palace of Pharaoh. And he had tremendous love for Israelites. He wanted to save Israelites by his muscle power. And he attempted, and we know he had to run away. So when he tried his way, he's completely failed. But many years later, God has chosen him, sent him to Pharaoh, and he has seen already the mighty work of God happening in Pharaoh's, in Egypt. And he has seen the miracles. He has seen the Red Sea dividing. Now he knows by this time, when we read chapter 33, he knows very clearly God has ways to accomplish, things in our life. So he prayed, God, show me your way. In this particular context, Moses had a problem. What was his problem? Israel has committed sin and God didn't want to accompany them. Now Moses is praying. Moses is asking, God, you told me, to bring up these people here, but you never told me who is going to come and help me, who is going to come with me and help him. So I am asking you, please show me your way. I do not know how to take forward these people from this place to, the promised land. I don't want to do it with my own strength, my own wisdom. I want to know your way. Hallelujah. He prayed for revelation of God's way. And what happened? Bible says in Psalms number 103, verse number 7, he made known his ways to Moses. When he prayed, what happened? God revealed God's ways to Moses, instructed him, and showed him what kind of step he has to take, how he should move forward. I want to tell you that there are times we struggle to take decision. There are times we don't know what kind of step we need to take, but the best thing that you can do, keep your life in the center of will and ask the Lord, give me your way, show me your way, tell me what I should do. I want to tell you that He will reveal His ways to each one of us. Hallelujah. This is very important because God has a plan for us, and we need to know how God wants to accomplish that plan in our life. That's why we should have a revelation about God's way in our personal life. And why we don't wait for getting that revelation sometimes, right? Sometimes we don't wait to receive a revelation about God's ways. We know we are doing something according to God's will, but we do not wait for how no, God wants to accomplish that in our personal life. Sometimes we move forward with our own understanding and fail. So that's why the next few seconds I want to just speak to you. Why people do not wait for God's way? Why people do not wait for God's way? I want to bring the example of Abraham and Moses and share a few points. First of all, people do not wait for God's way to reveal in their life because they see impossibilities in their life. When people see impossibilities, they switch over into their own plan, their own ways to accomplish things in their life. And best example is Abraham. And Abraham had a promise. What was promised? I will give you a child. But he was waiting for quite a long time. He didn't get a child. Then what he did? He went to the presence of God and said, God, make this Eleazar as my heir. God clearly told God would give him a child as a heir, but he's just thinking that his servant Eleazar may become his heir. You see how he bringing his plan before the Lord? In another occasion, God appeared to Abraham in chapter 17, and clearly God told to Abraham that he will have a child through Sarah. But he didn't believe. Bible says in 17, verse number 17, he laughed. He laughed and he asked, how an old man will have a child? How a Sarah who is 90 will have a child? He could not believe it. He saw only impossibilities before him. And then he said this to God in verse number 18. Abraham said to God, oh, that Ishmael might live before you. Now he's saying, let Ishmael be blessed. Let Ishmael be my heir. You bless him. I don't want another child. When you see impossibilities, please don't bring your plans before the Lord. Wait for God's plan to reveal. Wait for God's ways to reveal. Surely he will show you the right path you need to go forward in your life. Amen. And secondly, why we don't wait for God's plan? Because we sometimes listen others' plan for us. We sometimes listen others' plan for us. And do you know, Abraham and Sarah were waiting for this child, their own child. They didn't get it immediately. And what Sarah did, once Sarah came up with a nice plan, she called Abraham and said, take my slave girl, Hagar, and have a child with her. And Abraham listened to that, and we know what all kind of problems happened because of that wrong choice, that their own way, going on their own way. So sometimes we just miss God's ways in our life because we just carried away with others' plan. People in our life may come and say, this is good for you, do it. But we need a discernment. Yes, we need counsel, but ultimately we should be able to recognize what is God's will for us and what is God's ways for each one of us. We should not be carried away with others' suggestions and plans for our life. Thirdly, why we don't do God's way? Why we don't recognize God's way? Sometimes we lack understanding of God's ways. We miserably fail to understand the ways of God in our life. I already mentioned his ways are sometimes strange. His ways are sometimes mysterious. His ways are sometimes supernatural. His ways are always higher than us, sometimes unimaginable to human being. So that's why we sometimes won't be able to recognize, understand, fail to understand God's way in our life. Best example is Peter. Jesus told to his disciple, he will be arrested in Jerusalem and he will be killed there. Peter could not understand that. Peter immediately rebuked Jesus Christ. You know, in God's way, in God's plan, Jesus had to die. That's the way God wanted to bring salvation to humanity. That was God's plan, but Peter completely failed to understand that. But little later, after resurrection, when Holy Spirit came upon Peter, he could see the God's plan, how God's plan was upon Jesus Christ to die on the cross and accomplish salvation for humanity. So sometimes we don't follow God's way because we don't understand God's ways in our life. And lastly, we don't recognize God's way or fail to follow God's way because sometimes we take things into our hand. We depend upon our own strength. We depend upon our own knowledge. We have sometimes overconfidence on ourselves, our experiences, our knowledge, and we take our own way. Hallelujah. Example is Moses, and I already mentioned this. He was in palace. He wanted to save Israelites. What he did, he tried to actually, rescue Israelites with his own power, his own strength, and we know it failed. He had to run away from palace, and he had to spend next 40 years shepherding the flocks of his father-in-law. From where to where he gone, he came down. Dear church, I want to remind you that we should not depend upon our own strength and put overconfidence in our own ways of doing things. Rather, we need to wait for God and asking him, show me your way, Lord. Show me your way. And Moses learned this principle that he should follow God's way. I already mentioned that. He should follow God's way. If you read Exodus chapter 3 and 4, and we know God appeared to Moses and showed him what is his plan to deliver Israelites from Egypt. And Moses was sent back to Egypt to deliver Israelites. This time, Moses is not in his way. This time, he is not trying to accomplish anything by his own strength. Rather, he is trying to accomplish something through God's means and God's ways. And here is the few things I want to mention to you. When we follow God's way in our life, we have certain blessing following in our life. If you follow God's way in your life, if God has a plan for you and God has a way for you, if you follow that plan in your life, that way in your life, then there are certain blessings over you. If you read Exodus chapter 3, verse number 12, it says, "But I will be with you, and this shall be the sign for you." And Bible says here in this passage, if Moses followed God's ways of accomplishing his plan on this earth, then God will be with Moses. That's the first thing I want to remind you. When we follow God's way, he is going to be with us. We will not be left alone. He is going to be with us. And you know, his presence makes difference in our life. His presence, his accompanying presence will make difference in us. That's why Moses prayed, if your presence is not coming with us, please do not send us from here. What make me and my people special before you, unique in this world, is your presence. Dear church, what make us unique, powerful, supernatural in this world, his accompanying presence in our life. Hallelujah. When his presence comes from Joseph's life, we know it prospers us. It brings favor to each one of us. When his presence is with us, he will lead us into success, and he will help us to accomplish whatever we are doing with our hand. Dear church, follow God's way. He will stand with you. He will be with you. He will accompany you and enable you to accomplish that purpose in your life. And verse number 8 onwards, if you read, 18 onwards, if you read in Exodus chapter 3, verse number 18 onwards, if you read, and God gives him a direction. That's the second blessing we have. If you follow God's way in your life, he is going to give you directions in your life. Hallelujah. And Bible says here in verse number 18, God told Moses a plan, a way, an instruction, a step to take. What is that? He said, go to Egypt, call all the elders, and go to Pharaoh. Tell him that God of Hebrews appeared to us, and you need to send us to wilderness to worship him for 3 days. And then, he also revealed to Moses, Pharaoh will not send you immediately. Then I will show you miracles there, and you will not come out empty-handed. You will, bring out all the wealth of Egypt, with you. And we know that exactly happened. What is happening here? God showed him a way. In that way, God has given him directions, the step that he need to take in his life. Hallelujah. See, this is the privilege that we have. When we follow God's way in our life, he is going to instruct us. He is going to direct us. He is going to tell us what kind of step we need to take. Dear church, in your job place, if you have a trouble, or anything that you are doing in your life according to his will, if you have an issue, if you are a struggle, if you do not know how to go forward, I want to ask you, Please pray to the Lord, show His direction in your life. If you are in the center of God's will, He is faithful to show a direction for you. Show you a wisdom. Show you a step that you need to take. He will direct you. So He will be with us and He will direct our path. He will give us a plan. He will show us the steps that we need to take in our life. And when you continuously read in chapter 4, verse number 1 onwards, if you read, here it says, you know, Moses put down his, God asked Moses to put down his staff on the ground. All of a sudden, it became a snake. And then he had to pick up that snake and it became a staff. You know what happened that later you can see God is instructing him in verse number 17, take your hand, this staff with which you shall do the signs. What happened here? God supernaturally empowered, you know, Moses to do God's way, God's will in his life. So when we walk in God's ways, that's a third blessing that comes to our life. He will supernaturally empower us to do his ways, his will in our personal life. And Moses went to, you know, Egypt with that staff. He did miracle. He divided the Red Sea by using that staff. You can see amazingly God empowered Moses to do supernatural things in Egypt and outside because, you know, God empowered him. Dear church, when we walk in God's ways, this is another privilege God is going to give to us. He's going to empower us supernaturally. And when He empowers us, dear church, nothing will be impossible for us. Miracles start to take place in our personal life. And little later you can see Moses is telling verse number 10, you know, to God, I can't actually speak. And I am not eloquent. I am slow of speech and of tongue. And he's bringing his inadequacies before the Lord. And then God said, no, I will be with you. I will empower you to speak. And Moses was convinced. And then God said, you can have Aaron with you. And he will speak on behalf of you. What we are seeing here, you know, God, when God empowers, inadequacy is not a problem for God. Our weakness is not a problem for God. Our lack is not a problem for God. He can even transform our inadequacies and use us for His glory in a mighty way. Why God does this? This is the way sometimes God reveals His ways for us. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse number 27 onwards, what is foolish in this world, God uses because He wants to shame the wise in the world. What is weak in this world, He uses because He wants to shame the strong in this world. And God uses what is despised and low in this world because He didn't want anybody to take His glory. He didn't want anybody to boast, you know, in the presence of God. Dear church, remember this thing. Why God transforms your inadequacies? Why God uses your weakness? Why God uses even your inabilities? You know, reason? Because He didn't want to give the glory to any man. He want to take all the glory for Himself. Hallelujah. What He is accomplishing in your personal life. Dear church, this morning I want to tell you that do not make an excuse before the Lord saying that I am weak, I don't have that, I don't know this, and I don't know how to do that. Please don't make an excuse before the Lord. If God asks you to do something, He is empowering you to do that. He is giving you supernatural strength and ability to do that, and you will accomplish that. Hallelujah. That's why when we walk in God's way, He is going to supernaturally empower us to, you know, accomplish His plans in our life. Finally, when we walk in God's way, we will be able to accomplish more than what we can accomplish with our own strength. Look at Moses. He tried once to accomplish the salvation for Israelites, but completely failed. But now, with a stick, he didn't have an army, he didn't have a military, he didn't have a sword. With one stick, he went to Egypt and delivered the nation, delivered those slaves. This is the power God can show, demonstrate to an obedient person. Listen very carefully. When we walk in God's way, in short time, God can accomplish more than what we can accomplish in a lifetime. Hallelujah. When we walk in God's ways, God can accomplish more than what we can accomplish with our own education, our own ability, our own experience, our own money, hallelujah, our own strength, because he supernaturally empowers each one of us. Why Peter, why Paul, why many others, you know, impacted the world? Because God supernaturally empowered them and accomplished greater things in this world. Dear church, at this point of time in your life, I do not know where you are standing. And some of you know God's plan for your life, but you are wondering how it would happen in your life. But I want to tell you that if you know God's plan, God's will for your life, God's purpose for your life, you don't need to worry about your inadequacies. You don't need to worry about what you do not have. You do not need to worry about what kind of ability you have. Rather, you just ask the Lord, like Moses did, show me your way, Lord. Show me your way, Lord Father. Show me your way. He will supernaturally guide you. He will supernaturally show you his ways to us. Where there seems to be no way, he will show you his way for each one of them. He is a way maker. Hallelujah. Probably you are seeing everything is impossible in your life. Please believe me, God is a way maker. He will come down if you live according to his will and make a way for you. Hallelujah. Some of you have taken things into your hand. You have chosen your own way. You messed up in your life. You do not know what to do next. But I want to tell you that you have a time to come by. You have an opportunity to come by. Moses got a second opportunity, a second chance to come back to God's way and accomplish his purpose in his life. The same way today, if you are ready to actually surrender before the Lord, hallelujah, he can actually clear your mess and bring back you, redeem you to his plan and lead you and further and accomplish every purpose he has for you in your personal life. Hallelujah. I want to encourage you this morning. Decide to walk in God's ways. Hallelujah. Instead of taking things in our own hand, making our own choice, let us all take an opportunity to ask the Lord, Lord, instruct me, Lord. Show me your way, Lord Father. If we do that, he's going to show us supernatural ways in us. Hallelujah. His ways are higher than our ways. Can we all bow down our heads right now and pray together? Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus Christ. And Jinsey and Noel, would you please come forward and sing that song very once, you know, where there seems to be no way, God will make a way. Everyone, close your eyes today, right now. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, dear church, I want to request you. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. If you are not seeing any way forward, ask the Lord, show me your way. If you are seeing every door is closed, ask the Lord, show me your way, Lord. Hallelujah. And I want to request you, surrender everything before the Lord. In your workplace, if you have a trouble, surrender it to the Lord. In your family, if you have a trouble, surrender it to the Lord. In your education, you have a trouble, surrender it to the Lord. If you have issues with your finance, what kind of decision you need to make, you do not know, surrender it to the Lord. He has a way for you. Hallelujah. He has a plan for you. He has a will for you. And he has a ways to accomplish in your life. Hallelujah. Ask the Lord, God, show me your way, Lord. Show me your way, Lord Father. Show me your way, Lord Father. Hallelujah. Father, I pray for everyone who is hearing me today. Show them your way, Lord Father. As we sing this song right now, every closed door may be open. You may go before your people and make a way for them, Lord. Sing.
He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength for each new day, He will make a way. He will make a way. I'm away in the wilderness, believe me. Rivers in the desert,
church. I want to tell you that God is releasing His light upon you. If your path is dark, you do not know what to do, I've seen a tremendous light coming upon some of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you do not know what to do next in your life, Lord is showing this light upon you. Our Lord is also revealing to us, He is, some of you are in wilderness season, but it's over. It's over. He is making a way for you. He is making a way for you. Some of you are in this desert. God is making a river there right now. Receive this by faith, church. This is a moment of deliverance right now, church. Moment of breakthrough in your life right now. Wherever you are, just pray right now. Hallelujah. If you are written off certain things in your life, saying that it won't happen, it won't work, it won't happen, no hope, Lord is working on that. Hallelujah. God is working on that right now. Like Abraham, you're writing off, this won't happen. It's impossible. It is impossible. My situation, my resources are not sufficient to do this. It is impossible. You are writing off that. But Lord's way is going to manifest in that. Ramashakatana siatana. Hallelujah. 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 Amen, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We don't preach prosperity gospel in this church. But Lord is showing me very clearly, God is opening certain financial door for some of you. He's opening some financial door. Unusual, unexpected, hallelujah, financial door. In Jesus' name, let it happen right now. Let it happen right now. Let it happen right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, let it happen. A multiplication. A multiplication. Hallelujah. Oh, Rima Shakatana. Let me give you this confirmation this evening, this morning. Dear church, if you are praying, if you are praying, He is making a way for you. He is making such a new way for some of you right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. I see Lord is releasing certain breakthroughs over some of you right now. Receive that breakthrough. A breakthrough to go forward. Breakthrough to handle the impossibilities. Breakthrough, hallelujah, or to get over your wilderness season. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. We release that breakthrough, Lord. We release that breakthrough, Lord. Hallelujah. I want to request you, if anybody is struggling with an impossibility in your life, if you are battling to do certain things but it's not happening, you are stopped every time, you are not able to make a progress, it stopped, just, you know, like a force coming and stopping you, it just stopped. Many attempts you made, but it's just stopped. You are not able to make one inch progress in that. If you have that kind of issues in your life, bring to the presence of God right now. He is going to send you a breakthrough. Father, I pray for people who are struggling to make progress. In Jesus' name, I speak a breakthrough over them. Miracles are happening, church. In Jesus' name, I release that miracles over people. Let it happen right now. That breakthrough happen right now. Just believe me, God is moving for you. He is making a way. He is doing a miracle for you. In Jesus' name, let it happen right now. Let it happen right now. Let it happen right now. Oh, Rabba Shakatana Ziyatana. Every impossible thing, in Jesus' name, make it possible right now. Hallelujah. Every closed doors, in Jesus' name, be opened right now. Hallelujah. I pray every wilderness season, in Jesus' name, breakthrough right now. Breakthrough right now. Breakthrough right now. Hallelujah. Lord is showing me some of you are battling with certain things. No breakthrough. It just drains out your energy. It drains out your hope and peace. You are getting a breakthrough right now over them. Hallelujah. Come on, church. Lord is moving today. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. You are getting a breakthrough right now. Things that are draining your energy, things that are taking away your peace, things that are taking away the joy in your life, in Jesus' name, I speak a breakthrough. I speak a breakthrough right now. Every demonic weapon that fashion against your people, in Jesus' name, I command, go away. Breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Deliverance in the name of Jesus. Deliverance. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you for listening, Lord. Thank you for listening us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The love of Father God and grace of Son Jesus Christ and fellowship of Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen. Amen.